Hi everyone, my name is Shikin from Ras Aquaculture. Many of our clients will ask how we should treat the tap water before using it for our culture. In this episode, we will be talking about thiosulfate, which is a chemical that keeps our culture water chlorine free. Stay tuned. Groundwater and filtered tap water are the two most common water sources adopted in aquaculture activities. Unlike groundwater, tap water goes through the water treatment process, in which chlorine is added to it during the process to eliminate waterborne pathogen. Similar to potassium permanganate and iodine that we have discussed before, chlorine is also an indiscriminate disinfectant that kills all living cells. It can irritate crabs and shrimp gill tissue and damage the animal's soft and vulnerable skin tissue as the animals molt. In order to neutralize the residual chlorine contained in the tap water, thiosulfate is added. In our farm, sodium thiosulfate crystals are used. When the thiosulfate crystals are added to the tap water, they dissolve and react with the chlorine residues to turn the chlorine into harmless ions. Generally, sodium thiosulfate solution or crystal with 1% concentration are used. To illustrate, 10 ml or if crystal is used, 10 g of sodium thiosulfate is added to a 1000 liter of water. It should be added as soon as the tap water is added to the current culture water to prevent any detrimental effects to the animal culture. While there are a lot of anti-chlorine products out there in the market, most of them are using thiosulfate in the various forms. We hope you enjoy this episode on aquaculture chemistry. For those in Malaysia, we also included the link to purchase it over our Shopee shop. For international clients or clients that are interested in bulk purchase, feel free to get in touch at sales@rasaquaculture.com with us if you require assistance. If you have any question regarding the content, feel free to comment below. Thank you for watching.